And welcome to the Benchmarking 2.0 interview series, where we take a deeper dive into interesting projects identified during this year's performance strategy sessions. My name is Elizabeth Butler, and I'll be your host for today. For those who may be new, the Benchmarking 2.0 project allows municipalities to compare their service and performance trends with other participating units. Each year, we host performance strategy sessions at the School of Government to discuss data trends and best practices. Today, we are joined by Captain Bryan Adams, who is a Support Services Division Commander for Hickory's Police Department. Thank you, Bryan, for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
To start today's interview, what do you think is something everyone should know about Hickory?
Hickory is my birthplace. I've been here all my life. It's an amazing city. It's grown tremendously over through my lifetime. Obviously, we're in a big growth pattern right now. It's a very exciting time to be in Hickory. We have a sleeping population of about 41,000. As I said, we're in a big growth pattern right now. There's a lot of construction going on, and but we're a hub, if you will, for the area. So on a daily basis, we have anywhere from 100,000 to 120,000 people in our city. So our population actually grows tremendously through the daytime. And then and through that growth I'm talking about, there's a big walk and trail system that the city has done an amazing job to bring to our city that's being constructed right now, that hopefully will be finished sometime this summer, to where it's close to 13 miles total, which will be a city walk going through the middle of our city, goes down to Lake Hickory and goes out onto the river walk. And then it'll be connecting to an aviation walk in Hickory. So it's an exciting time. There's a lot of things going on here.
That's very exciting to hear. So during our performance strategy sessions, other participants were interested in learning more about Hickory's use of apprenticeship programs. To learn more about these programs, we'd like to ask you a couple of questions. The
sure,
first
yes, ma'am.
Question is, how does Hickory use apprenticeship programs such as ApprenticeshipNC to attract and recruit prospective employees?
So currently, we are working with Catawba Valley Community College, and their program there is Catawba Apprenticeship Network. And so we partner with them, and they have a coordinator there that's in charge of that program. And through them, we go out and we partner with her, and we go out and we meet students on site at all the schools in our county. We just did a tour recently, if you will, and we went out to the vast majority of all the high schools in our county. And last week, we actually just had all the students that were interested after that tour of all those schools, to where we went out and presented, you know, the apprenticeship program, and not just us, but all the other industries in our county that are part of that network. They went out and did that tour. And then last week, all those students and their parents actually came to Catawba Community College to come back and hear more, and actually come up and ask us questions and to see about how to get involved in the program. Did that answer your question?
That did. And that sounds wonderful. So when and why did you all decide to use apprenticeship programs to attract and recruit new employees? And how did you decide to partner with them?
So we have talked about for years that we really want to focus on keeping local kids local, keeping our local people here. And that was kind of driven by, at the time, that our command staff, which consisted of five people, four of the command staff were from Hickory and had gone to Hickory City schools and in another school in the county as well, too. So it's just bringing that passion for a city that you grew up in and keeping it local. So we've always wanted to focus on keeping local kids local. About a year and a half ago, we went to a program at a local agency, to where it wasn't a police agency, but it was an emergency communications department, and they were looking at starting an apprenticeship program for telecommunicators. Well, we sat through that program because we actually have telecommunicators here at our police department as well. And so I sat through that program, and when I got to the end of it, I was like, well, this is great, and we're excited about this for telecommunicators, but in my mind, like, why can't we do this for police officers as well too? And so when I was thinking about how that could work for a police officer, it went back to what I was saying earlier. That's a great way to keep local kids local. So we started having conversations with the apprenticeship people, with Catawba Community College, and then it evolved from there. So it's been a great relationship and partnership so far.
That's great. Could you also talk a little bit more about how the apprenticeship program works?
So the apprenticeship program, the person has to be 18 years of age. Obviously, we can start having conversations with them earlier, from the time they're a freshman in high school to start telling them about the program. But essentially, just in a nutshell, if they became interested, they would interview with us. They would go through our full hiring process as a part-time employee. We would hire them as a security aide at the age of 18 because they have to be 18 years old before they get into the program. They can still be in high school at that point, but they have to be 18 years old. And they can be finished with high school, but they have to be, and don't quote me on this, but I think they have to be within a 120-day window from the time that they graduated to get into the apprenticeship program. There are some other stipulations that I think that they can be brought in after that, but I don't want to say those here today and be misquoted, so or say some incorrect information. But essentially, we would hire them. They would be going to school. The Apprenticeship North Carolina would pay for their education. They would be involved in a criminal justice program at Catawba Valley Community College. They would work for us part-time, 20 hours a week. They would be embedded in our police department at the age of 18. In the state of North Carolina, you can go to BLET when you're 20 years old currently to be a police officer. So the goal would be for them to work here for 2 years part-time, be embedded in our police department, doing ride-alongs with our police officers, out being a security aide on the walk system that I explained a few minutes ago, being out on our own doing that security aid patrol, being in our comm center with our telecommunicators, and basically being embedded in our police department in every aspect of it to learn our culture. So hopefully when they get to 20 years old, that they're to the point to where we can send them to BLET, which is basic law enforcement training, and then they can go be certified to be a police officer. Then at around 21 years of age, they would finish, and then they would come to work for us as a police officer and have the culture of our department already in them and know and have vital skills that they've learned on the job here at the place that they would actually be working as a police officer.
That sounds really interesting. So is there kind of like a certain number of students you take in for this program each year, or it's just, is there any, you have any limits or anything?
Well, because it takes 2 years for them to finish the program, because we hire them at 18, and then they, have to be 20 before, but before they would go to BLET, they would be in this program for 2 years essentially. Right now, we have four positions. We have one current. There's one in the hiring process. We should be hiring anytime. We actually have an explorer program here in Hickory that we've had for years, and we have one of our current explorers who is 17 now and will be 18 in the next coming months. Is still in high school, and they are very interested. So hopefully that slot, could potentially go to them. And then there's a fourth person right now that's in a that we're having conversations with to hopefully that they would fill our fourth slot.
That sounds
And
great then.
we have four slots right now, but not to say that we wouldn't add more in the future.
No, for sure. Future capacity is definitely something to consider.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what data, if any, was used to make the decision or highlight the need, for these apprenticeship programs?
Well, the need, obviously, just around the country and in all industries and in all kinds of workforces, there's a reduction in employees, and that has hit the law enforcement industry very hard as well too. Most agencies around the country have a deficit in their workforce right now. So obviously we had a small deficit in ours, and we wanted to do something to combat that. This is obviously, I told you, it's a 2 year process. It's not a short term fix, but we're looking at the long term fix. How do we get young, again, how do we get young people to stay in Hickory and police where they grew up and to have a funnel system, if you will, for them to get into to actually to help this deficit that we're all facing right now in law enforcement, to where in the future to where we have people that are coming in at 18, and then we have applicants when they turn 21 that they've already been in our police department. So basically a long-term fix, if you will, for the recruitment problem that's going on currently in our country and in our state.
That definitely makes sense. So you kind of saw that you kind of needed new, you needed some more employees, basically, and you kind of saw how you could create a pathway with the apprenticeship program for them.
Yes, ma'am.
So are there any costs associated with the apprenticeship programs?
Well, we do pay them 20 hours a week, so they do come and they actually work for us 20 hours a week. So obviously, they have a salary that they get paid. They get an hourly wage. They start out at a certain rate, and through the apprenticeship program, they have to go up in increments, which is part of the requirements for the apprenticeship program through Apprenticeship North Carolina. I'm sorry, would you ask that question again?
No worries. Are there any other costs associated with the apprenticeship program?
For us, that's it. We do pay them currently, pay them a stipend as well too. So they work 20 hours a week for us. They get compensated for that work, and then they also receive a stipend as well too.
Sounds great. So far, what do you like about the apprenticeship program? And how has the program helped you?
Again, going back, I think it's going to be a long-term help for the recruitment problem that's going on currently in our state and our country. What I like about it is it's keeping local kids local. Our apprentice right now is currently an Hispanic female. One of the things that law enforcement needs drastically is females in the law enforcement profession, and so we're very excited that our first hire in the apprenticeship program was a female. So we're super excited about that. Our current applicant that's in the process is also an Hispanic female, and one of the other applicants currently is a female. So we're really excited about that because that is a super big need in law enforcement currently in our state and in our country. So, but again, it's keeping local kids local. These kids are from local schools. Both of these are from the high school that are in our city currently, and so we're excited about that.
That definitely makes sense. So, if you could, what changes would you make to improve the apprenticeship program?
Currently, we've only had our current apprentice here about 6 or 7 months, and so currently it's working great. CBCC and Apprenticeship North Carolina, I'm sorry, it's Catawba Valley Community College and Apprenticeship North Carolina. They have been amazing. The employees that we've worked with there have helped to make this process very easy for us to work out and to create here at our city. And so currently there's nothing we would change. Things are going very smooth and
That's great to hear. So it sounds like the benefits definitely outweigh the costs, and that you've kind of experienced minimal challenges in terms of this apprenticeship program.
yes, ma'am. If I can go back and add, currently, and not quoting people from the Apprenticeship North Carolina, but currently, when you were asking about cost, I would just put out there that currently, through Apprenticeship North Carolina, there is funding, grant funding, and they would have all the exact grants, but there's current funding to where that grant will pay for a certain percentage of the apprentice back to the agency for the first 2 years, I believe it is. So that grant funding actually pays you back to have apprentices. So the cost is we're paying that salary and that stipend, but the agency will get a percentage of that stipend and that salary back for the first 2 years. So it's very lucrative as well too. For the student and for everyone involved, thanks to the grant funding currently.
Yeah, and that's very helpful to know in terms of costs, particularly for programs like these. To kind of wrap up this interview, do you have any advice for other police departments who are thinking about adopting a similar apprenticeship program?
You have to have something for them to do. Obviously, we are very fortunate in the city of Hickory to where we have this new walkway that I spoke about, and to where we had a need for that to be patrolled, and obviously we're have a shortage of officers, And so we said, hey, this would be great for them to be out. This would be a civilian security patrol person to do that. So we're very fortunate to be able to have a position to do that. So, you know, ultimately you would have to have something for them to go out to do, to be embedded inside your department, to learn the culture, to learn the skills about how to be a police officer, you know, to get them plugged into doing things in your city that are going to be in line with the job of being a police officer.
That definitely makes sense. So I'd like to now say thank you, Bryan, for taking the time to speak with us today. We enjoyed learning more about Hickory's use of apprenticeship programs. I'm sure that our audience also found this information very helpful.
Thank you so much.
To our listeners, thank you for joining us today. Please check out the Benchmarking 2.0 website and dashboard, and we look forward to see you all in the next interview.